To Bob's Pet Farm. Welcome on in to the next episode, which is already episode number 10 of this project. And today we are going to build the bison habitat. And this is actually going to be one of my favorite ones because the habitat is a little bit different from what we've done so far. So the last habitats were all kind of integrated into the overall farm, as you may have seen. However, this is today a little bit more of a open wild field, you know, and I found actually some new flowers, which are not new at all, but I just kind of ignored them for the last year, and I have no idea why, but I ignored them. And it turned out that these look phenomenal to create some very nice flower-ish looking fields, and this looks really dang good. I gotta admit, this looks way better than I actually thought. So today is very special, simply because we are already in episode number 10. That means if everything was going to plan, we are already 5 weeks into me being a dad. If this is a thing, I am quite sure that I have been on YouTube already again, and you have seen some other content as well. So again, a little reminder, this is all pre-recorded. I really still hope you guys love the project. It's running still, and you know, if I do run out of space to put out videos, I might have speeded up this project and released 3 episodes a week. I don't know. I don't know yet what future Rudy is doing. So potentially, I'm just gonna remind you that this is all done pre-March DLC. April DLC. I don't even know when it's going to be released, but it's pretty sure that there is a DLC coming and a update. I have no clue what it does contain of. I only know that is something coming. And it is the point that I'm recording this. We have already seen the official forum post from Shantae that they will shortly show us something, what they have been up to. It's kind of funny now for you to listen to it, because I'm pretty sure that we are already a couple of weeks in and the DLC might have already been it's already, but people are bored already again, so it doesn't really matter anymore if there's new content or not, if Frontier has not surprised us all with a huge little update, which I don't know, but I think if they do a crazy update, it might be first summer, but yeah, you know, you never know. This area over here, by the way, is a little special area. I don't know, this is a little special thing I just wanted to do at some point, so, this is just, it's very useless, but I love the fact that it is here. So it's kind of a little small, tiny canyon where you have some plants in, some rocks fallen over, and just as a little natural barrier to the habitat where the fence is ending. I love this little detail, you know, just so you do see a little bit of it by just quickly, you know, keeping your eyes on this when you go all the way to the mill. And if not, it's just there. You know that it's there, and it's not even... You know, it's not even too visually concerning in the entire process, but it's there, and it's something to look at and make this area look a bit more interesting than it actually would be without it. I mean, if that makes sense. And you can see I just put down a lot of fences over here that are going to be hidden away by trees. I gotta admit, though, I got a little bit too efficient maybe with this. I could have done this all with like custom fences and so on, but it would have not added anything to the project. So again, this whole project was a little bit more about making things look good, work out very nice and so on, in a rather more efficient way to squeeze that all into the project I was planning. And I gotta admit, it does also change the view on the game for me now a little bit, and I will talk about this maybe in a tutorial, maybe in the video, but I always used to be very perfectionist when it comes to all these things in this game, to make sure that every single bit is handmade. I did not use anything from the store. I did not use anything from the in-game that is pre-made. I always needed to make it myself, and I wasn't happy until I did. Now, with this project, things changed a little bit, and I think this is down to the fact that this is Planet Zoo and not Planet Coaster. In Planet Coaster, I always had the feeling that I could make things better then I could see them elsewhere. And that was just a very personal drive. I wanted to make things better in my eyes, okay? And I'm not taking this as an objective judgment because that's impossible. It's just my very personal subjective thing. And I kind of wanted to also have the little proud feeling of making it myself and having that as a part of my build. And I can always say this is all what I did. Things changed, obviously, with the Team TK. When this was released, I just did not have the time, rather the skills, to do all these 3D objects. And I was happily using stuff from the store as well. And this is also where things change a little bit, because then the actual assembly becomes the real skill and becomes the real talent you have to have, rather than using those simple pieces. And as we are talking here about a zoo game where it's all about the feeling, the atmosphere, the habitats and so on, sometimes it might really not be that important to have everything done yourself. That said, you will also see some Steam Workshop elements in this series, actually. I have used them at the very end in the next episode, I guess, and in episode number 12 as well. You will see these elements being used, I will have a collection done on Steam, so in case you want to give these people a little like and a follow and give the credit to where it belongs, I have it in there. This is, by the way, the flower asset I was talking about. Look, I mean, this is kind of cool because it is so nice. I wish we could change the color of the flowers, but we couldn't. But that's okay. We can deal with this little purple, violet, bluish tint. And I squeezed some of the underwater plants in as well. They look kind of cool as grass. I remember that Haribo did this in a very excessive way. Not gonna lie, everything that Haribo does is in an excessive way, but he knows it and it's fine, you know? He's melting computers and then he needs my help to load his project again. Sent him the file where I look into the sky so that, you know, the computer is not melting away. That's kind of funny though. It's a little bit of a nice side note here to Haribo. I hope he's fine. But that was always fun. Anyhow, guys, that should be it for my talky talk through the real-time part. We'll see each other now in, the time-lapse, sorry. We'll see each other now in the real-time part in a couple of minutes. I hope you enjoyed and we talk later. Hey everyone, and here we are in the real-time part of the bison habitat. And oh boy, this is exactly what I said. Also, I have to correct myself. I decided to put also ostriches within here. So I thought this was a good idea to bring them all in because I think this makes the whole habitat even better. So you can see, oh, look at that. They do just like each other quite a lot here. So we get some babies. That's very nice. Even with those fluffy dudes rubbing each other. That is the most cozy thing to do, I guess, with all these fluffy things. Oh yeah, he's just pooping out of fun. Okay, that's great. Enjoyment and squashing the water off because that was very sweaty, of course. Oh boy. But yeah, so this is the bison habitat. And I think the view from over here is just absolutely gorgeous. And this is what I meant. She's running now over to the otters and can see how nice this this little mill is now integrated in the back part of this area. We have a few, you know, chests and stuff that I created to just block this area off to make it a bit more realistic. That's the little canyon I was talking about just in the end. You know, you don't notice it until you notice it. It's just really nice in here. And then if we fly over, you can see, look, the bison's there in the background. And with this little river floating through here, this is just kind of a very nice view. I mean, just look at that. Just take that in. It's, boy, that looks so good. And I am, again, very happy with how this all turns out. If you zoom out a little bit, you can really see how that all is forming each other. And again, I didn't really put too much emphasis on the back part because you can't really see it anyways, you know. When you go through here, this is all you see, and then you can basically just, you know, ignore the rest a little bit here, because again, you just can't see it. So that's basically about it, and I think we see each other in the next episode. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Stay safe, everyone, and I talk to you in the next one.